Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home. Settle down, it'll all be clear. Don't pay no mind to the demons, they fill you with fear. The trouble in my drag.
I'm Teresa.
David.
We're retired and road tripping. We are in our hometown of Fulton, Missouri. We decided to do a video. We're going to show you some of our favorite things. And right now we're down here on Stinson Creek Trail. We're going to start at the National Churchill Museum.
Yes.
That's on Westminster College campus. We're going to take you to the city park where the Festival of Lights is. Do you like this kind of content? We do road trips. We do a lot of free camping videos. If you like that kind of stuff, make sure and hit the subscribe button so you don't miss any. Dave, I guess let's go finish our walk here on the creek and let's go over to the museum. In 1946, Westminster College President Frank McClure issued a bold invitation to Winston Churchill to come and speak on the campus of Westminster College in Fulton, Missouri. After the endorsement of President Harry S. Truman, Winston Churchill agreed and delivered the Iron Curtain speech located at the historic gym that is still located on the college campus.
From Stettin in the Baltic to Trieste in the Adriatic, an iron curtain has descended across the continent.
That Winston Churchill would actually really accept that invitation?
So when President McClure, who was the president of Westminster College at the time, sent the invitation to invite Winston Churchill here at Westminster College, they didn't really think he would accept the invitation. That was until they had a former alumnus named Harry Vaughn, who actually worked in the White House with President Harry Truman, who was from Independence, Missouri. They sent that letter to Vaughn, who presented it to President Truman, who actually endorsed Churchill coming to speak here, saying, "This is a small school in my home state. Hope you can do it. I'll introduce you to President Harry Truman." And then I sent the invitation on to Winston Churchill. And when Churchill realized that a sitting president of the United States was going to be there with him here in Fulton, Missouri at Westminster College, he couldn't say no.
Fulton turned out for a big, huge parade. 25,000 people lined the streets. They made it a big deal. After the speech, and it was very successful, and it's been actually very historic, the school decided to commemorate that speech by bringing in the church from London.
So can you talk to us about how the church ended up here at school?
Yeah, so the Church of St. Mary, Alden Mary, was located in London and was actually destroyed during the Blitz in World War II. It remained in ruins after the war had ended. And the city of London was going to destroy the church, but Westminster College heard of that and they said, we'll just buy the church from you and bring it here to Fulton. That idea came about in 1961. By the time of 1969, they had actually dedicated the church and had it opened as part of the Winston Churchill Memorial and Museum here in Fulton. So from 1961, they had the idea. They tore the church down brick by brick in London in the mid-60s, put it on a ship, put it on a train here, and then put the stone out in a parking lot here on campus and started building it from the ground up. The first stone was laid in October of 1966, and then the dedication was done in May of 1969.
Well, I know when I was over at William Woods, I think I was there at the right time because I came over. They had Ronald Reagan come and speak, George Bush, Margaret Thatcher, and Mikhail Gorbachev.
Yes, that's right. President Bush came when he was vice president, and the time he came in 1988. Former President Ronald Reagan was here in 1990. When the Berlin Wall was dedicated, which we have eight sections of here on campus. Gorbachev came in 1992, and then Margaret Thatcher.
I have got some video of the Berlin Wall out there. Interesting note, Winston Churchill's granddaughter?
His granddaughter, Irina Sands, she was an artist, and when the wall came down in Berlin, she actually went to Berlin and asked to buy these sections of walls. And when the German government found out she was Winston Churchill's granddaughter, said, no, you don't have to pay for them, we'll give them to you. And they did, and she cut out two silhouettes of a man and a woman. She called the sculpture Breakthrough. It was supposed to represent breaking through from communism into freedom, and that's located here on campus. And she donated that piece to the museum and the college.
Porter, do you have an event that kind of sticks out?
Yeah, when we did the 50th anniversary of the museum back in May of 2019, that was a big deal for not only the campus, the museum, but Fulton, but also for our community here in Fulton. I head up a project called a Special Relationship Project, which brought together all the school districts in Callaway County, which is where Fulton is located, and got them to participate in a school project that had their artwork displayed in the museum. And to my knowledge, the first time that all the school districts got together to work on a project like that. And that was something that I was very proud to be a part of.
Make sure you watch all the way to the end of this video. I've got some photos of the Special Relationship Project. And I know that for me, they had a movie premiere down at the church when The Darkest Hour came out. And they had huge spotlights and the red carpet. And I've got some photos of that. So make sure and stick around to the end to watch all of that. Thanks, Tyler, for all your information.
We're at the city park for the Christmas lights. This is a tradition for us. We're so proud of our little park and all the Christmas lights. They keep adding to it. We're walking down here to the Field of Joy. That's where the Christmas trees are that businesses and individuals can sponsor. They take that money and they add Christmas lights. And don't let all these people fool you. It's about 5 degrees and feels like negative 10. And there are a lot of people out here. Here we are at the Field of Joy. We have snow here. We were part of that blizzard, except we didn't get much, but it has been very cold. This right here is my daughter's fiance's tree. We helped decorate this little beauty right here. It was so much fun to do. It was our first time to do a tree down here. We're proud of it. This just keeps getting bigger and bigger every year. I guys wanted to show you what it looked like up above, overlooking our little city park with the Christmas lights. It's Christmas Eve. Park is full of people coming and going. It's cold.
Through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh, o'er the fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtails ring, making the spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight. Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells.
This bridge is very popular in Fulton. A lot of people come out here, get their graduation pictures taken, family pictures, wedding pictures. So Dave wanted to share the history of this bridge.
This bridge was built in 1878. It was used over at Grain Valley, Missouri. They took it apart and brought it over here to cross Stinson Creek in 1902 to go out to Carrington to the fire clay pits. They had fire clay that went to the Harverson Walker brick plant north of here, and they made fire bricks. And some of those fire bricks was used for NASA for the rocket program and space shuttle.
Yep, very interesting. We're at the Callaway County Courthouse.
To secede from the United States at the beginning of the American Civil War, Callaway County chose its own path. The local Callawayans seceded from the state of Missouri and fashioned themselves into an independent nation called the Kingdom of Callaway. They voted on that in October of 1861.
I obviously love Callaway County and Fulton. I've lived here my entire life. I've never actually lived anywhere other than Callaway County. When Dave and I first got married, we lived up at the Hatton area for a couple years, and then we built a house where we live now. Callaway County does have special meaning to us, and the National Churchill Museum means a lot to us. We got married there. Tyler got married there. Tyler worked there. Tyler worked his way up from work study to the director of operations there. So National Churchill Museum means a lot to us. We're standing in front of something that means a lot to Dave.
Well, I worked here at Fulton State Hospital for 33 years. Teresa's dad worked here, and Teresa's grandpa worked here. And he worked at the original Biggs building that opened in fall of 1939. That's the year Teresa's dad was born.
This building just got built, didn't it?
Yes, this is the third administration building.
Yeah. So we're here in front of where Dave put his heart and soul into this place. Actually, he was on call all the time. We couldn't go on a vacation without somebody calling him. So I guess this is gonna wrap up our video. Anything last words you want to say about anything about Callaway County, Dave? We hit it all.
Well, there's more, but can't think of it right now.
America's beautiful. Get out and see it if you can.
Like, subscribe if you want to.
We'll see you on the road.